All right, so you know the theme of these videos is a video idiot, and I keep learning things as I go, and believe it or not, I do have the phone this time on Do Not Disturb. I found out what happened with that mic. When I downloaded the Android 11 update, it reset all the damn settings, which I guess is understandable in a way. I'm sure they just can't know what the settings were before on the phone. And that's why the mic was turned off, and I got poor sound on a couple of videos that I recorded, and I didn't go back. The other thing is I noticed with the camera, you know, one of the things I've had is trouble trying to figure out how to get the phone level for filming. And it actually has a little line, tells you 0 degrees, 1 degree, so you can kind of adjust that, the phone, you know, for film. That's what I'm using for films, and I can get that angle just the way I want it. I got this at 1 degrees because I got a hill kind of sloping down this way, and I wanted to bring it up just a little bit. So I think that's going to work pretty nice. So what we've done is I've laid out the area here. I got my radio, got a couple beers, I got some water, got my Yeti water bottle. I got a stopwatch because we're gonna tear the tent down once we're done putting stuff inside it, and then I'm gonna do a time lapse video at 10x. I just wanted to show you a couple things that we're gonna do. this is for gear. It's gonna hang off the top of the tent somehow. There's no directions on this, so I assume it's gonna be intuitive. I'm gonna get in there. I'll hook this all up, and then I'll just show it to you. I'm not gonna film me hooking it up. The other thing is I just want to show you the quality of some of the bags. These are all those added tent pegs. I mean, look at this. These are for the guidelines. I mean, there's just a whole horde of them in here. Boy, you stick that tent out, that's all solid steel. Here's something that I added. Cabela's, if you order, because I ordered the floor liner for the tent, which I'm going to show you here in just a second. But you got to get up to $50. So I thought, well, what else can I use? And I thought, boy, a dry bag, because my old dry bags, you know, I'm getting old, man. The dry bags that I bought years ago, the inner liners are just flaking out of them. And it's just, it looks like, you know, a leprosy. I mean, everything's just kind of, they're not going to wear. They're not going to keep anything dry. I mean, they're still good bags if you want to peel all that plastic out from the inside. So I went ahead and bought this. I thought this was pretty cool. Because you can use this with a canoe. I mean, so if you're out and you're back, you know, camping, and all of a sudden you want to do a little whitewater rafting, or you want to go canoeing or something, you know, this can drag right in the water right behind you. You know, it's got the attachments and everything. Let me just tell you what it is. It's 30-ounce heavy-duty PVC waterproof material, roll-top design, seals contents for moisture, electronic welded seam construction, quick release, buckles ensure tight closure, D-ring hardware for secure attachment point, bonded webbing handle. So it's got a handle and you can just pick it up. Now, where does this come in for camping? Well, if I'm in that tent and I put the tent in a bad place, or let's say I'm in my overnight tent and I get rain and stuff, I can just take everything and put it in this bag and it's going to stay dry, no matter if the tent gets flooded or not. Well, this Cabela's tent, unless you're sitting in 2 feet of water, I don't think it's going to get flooded, but it, you know, it's possible. So this is a good option, and especially if you're going out for a hike and you're expecting some big bad thunderstorms, you can put everything, your sleeping bag and stuff, in this bag. And unfortunately, the big ones cost about the same price as a lower size, so you might be going, wow, I don't need something that big. Bigger's better. That's what I got to say. That's the same with TVs. This is the floor liner. We're going to put this in the tent. I'm not going to film that, but I'll show you. You know, one of the things Cabela's pointed out is this is going to be great for when the floor gets dirty. So you got some dirty shoes, you got debris and stuff in there, you can just pop this thing out and go wash it, whatever, in a washing machine or whatever you want to do, and get it nice and clean. That way the floor of the tent doesn't get dirty, because if you got to clean the floor of a tent, what are you going to do? Turn the tent inside out, try to clean the floor? No, you're just going to shake it out as best you can, get the debris out of there. But as far as like wiping it down and getting the mud off of it and everything like that, well, this is perfect. So, and also this is going to give you some added protection. You know, you put a little plastic chair in there, or you're sitting on a cooler or whatever, you know, it's got some sharp edges. Yeah, it's okay if it cuts into this, but you don't want it cutting into the floor of the tent. You know, that'd be a disaster. So I'm going to hook this all in. We're going to get a film of the floor, and then we're going to do that speed video that I was telling you about. And what I've laid out, you know, I talked about the radio, the beers, the water, and I'm going to act like I'm just getting to the campsite, and I'm just going to take my time. I got a stopwatch. We're going to start that, and we're going to film it, and this will be the final video. No more on the tent. But, I mean, this is your home. away from home. And I wanted to make sure I got this totally squared away. Boy, it's taken me almost 3 weeks to get these videos and everything up and learn how to do everything that I got to do so that I'm never again uncomfortable when I'm camping with a tent. All right, enough for now. All right, so we're gonna do this for real. Looks like we've arrived at our campsite. All I've done is empty everything out of the bag, got the hammer out, got the tent pegs. Now, I'm not going to tack out the guy lines like I didn't before, but we're going to record this on 10X. And, you know, if you just want to watch this video and not watch any of the other ones, that's fine, because hopefully everything that I've talked about in all the previous videos is going to come together in this one. And for you you Robin Hood kids out there, you young bucks, I'm actually using a watch with this stopwatch. I know these things are ancient technology to time this, and we're going to see how long it takes. I'm going to take my time. I got my water over here. I'm pretending that's a picnic table. Got some beer. Got the radio on. Let's see what happens. I'm going to start the watch now. There you go. Now, in theory, we're not quite done because we haven't staked out the guidelines. But if I was coming in for the first night and I wasn't expecting, you know, a hurricane to come through, that'd be adequate. And then maybe you might stake them guidelines after. You know, this is exactly what I was trying to simulate. We didn't get started till 4 o'clock. Well, about 4:30, you know, because that's, if you're traveling, you know, you're going to arrive, you know, late in the day. And it took 45 minutes. And I took my time. You saw us having a little beer and just drinking some water and listening to the radio. One thing, I mean, every time, that's about my sixth time setting the tent up just for these videos. But I wanted to be sure I'm comfortable with it. One thing that I noticed was the poles, you know, if you clip them into those pins, they just come right out, you know. So what I was learning was just take the pole and kind of jam it into the ground. And then just, you know, once you get it clipped in and everything, then you can clip them in on both sides. Not that you want the mud and the dirt in the end of the pole, but otherwise it just comes out anyway. So that was one thing I noticed. Other than that, I think we're set. You know, inside the tent, I've got that floor liner. So that didn't really add any, you know, anything to setting it up. Anyway, I'm real happy. I guess that's about it. We ain't doing no more with this tent. Now I got to take it down and put it away. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. I tried to get the camera just right, but who knows, you know. Every time I'm a video idiot, so I mess something up. All right.